It was a great fortune, I don't know when was it, that first time Prabhuji came to Pune, seeing him was like a fireball of enthusiasm. That was so inspiring. We always, as he said, look forward to his visit. Unfortunately, this time, the latest visit, I was out somehow. I could only attend Sunday morning or Gautam office. I was not present for earlier, maybe Saturday, Friday, the other days. But he's very enthusiastic. Seeing him, I feel like, I remember that verse, Tesham Satata Yuktanam Bhajatam Priti Purvakam. Always engaged and very blissfully engaged with love. So much, like he was telling him, that the Kirtan go on for millions of years. So you can see him in Kirtan, and so inspiring. He's fully giving, and not only personally absorbed, he requests us also. He will tell us, chant loudly, chant nicely. So it's very inspiring. Satata Yuktanam Bhajatam. That's why Dadami Bhutti Yogantam. He has got that wit by which he can answer the question so precisely. In Pune, I don't know whether it is the situation all over the world, very, very good. But in Pune itself, we have had maybe thousands of questions asked to him. And he also is able to answer so nicely. So many questions and so precisely. He doesn't have to give long answers. So people are also very happy. They are enthusiastic to ask many questions. But they know very precisely, to the point he speaks, not here and there. One of the statements I was hearing, he was saying that expansion is next to the training. Training is very important, training devotees. He trains very nicely. He was telling that how Guru loves his disciples. So he was telling that as I have come here, but I am looking for some of the devotees. Some disciples have come, maybe somebody was from Delhi, somebody was from Mumbai. He's saying it's natural for the Guru to look after his disciples. They are like sons. And so he is very concerned. So that is very nice because great souls like him, they love us. So they are very great fortune. So I especially look forward to his arrival. And that day somehow Prabhuji asked that question and I happened to raise hand. So then eventually our His Grace Chaitanya Chandra Prabhu also was inspired. Because next time also when he came, he was asking, where is that Brahmachari who has read all the books? So then I was there somehow, fortunately. So then I raised hand. So I said, okay, till now anybody else then? So still nobody was there. So Prabhuji got inspired. So I think by the third visit also, so he was not present here. But when he asked me, I said, one more Brahmachari is there. So he was asking, where is he? I said, he's out for maybe book distribution. So he's very intelligent and very, what you call, he remembers me. He's very high class. I don't know how he remembers. Every time he spots me out. This time also I heard that he was asking me about Brahmachari. That I was missing in the lectures. He was concerned me, where is he? Is he good? So he remembers us, that is our great fortune. And as he was telling, he loves Prabhupada so much and always enthusiastic. So he gives intelligent answers very nicely. Dadami Buddhi Yogantam Yenamam Upayantiti. Not only he has reached spiritual world, his conscience is always in the spiritual world. Only he drags us along with him to the spiritual world. When he's there, we feel so enthusiastic. In fact, the questions he answers, they are not only to the point, but he is very bold. And the kind of questions were asked about husband and wife, their relationship. So boldly he spoke. Maybe even the Brahmacharis like us will get scared that husband and wife should have nothing to do with each other, apart from producing a child. Otherwise, not even. And he said, I have been married for so many years. Because he is following her very strictly. That's why he can have the boldness. He can speak so. Even the Brahmacharis, though they have nothing to do with wife and all, but we get so much inspiration to be very chaste, to be very nice Brahmacharis because of his. Though he is apparently a grihastha, but actually he is way beyond the sannyasis also, because such a strict standard he follows. Because he follows, he can speak it so boldly. No hesitation, no all that kind of thing. Because very strictly he follows. And because he follows so nicely, his answers are so convincing, and his association is what will inspire us in the times to come and to follow him step by step. So he is way above us, but because he comes and he mercifully comes down to our level, picks us up, and through his answers he takes us ahead. So we are very, very fortunate. I look forward to his association, and we have a lot of inspiration. So I pray at this auspicious day of Prabhu's appearance that he blesses us always and through instructions and his prayers, which are the only hope for conditioned souls like us to be able to reach the Prabhupada and to the Supreme Lord. His grace and Krishna Das Adhikari Prabhu Ki Jai.